All right, team, here we are, Planet Ari.
Ooh, wow, it looks so nice.
Yes, we have a lot of important matters to discuss, but afterwards, I think it would be very beneficial if we went out to explore the planet and got to interact with the citizens of Planet Ari. After all, our major topic of discussion at this meeting is communication.
Yes, accurate and persuasive communication is going to be very important if we want the citizens of Planet Ari to meaningfully understand the information we are transmitting to them, especially if we want to sell our product, the X-Ray Alien. Yes, we've created this product specifically for them. The X-Ray Alien is meant to help the people of Planet Ari live healthier and more sustainable lives. That was very well said, Arwen, and a truthful statement at that. We only want the citizens and the planet to benefit from this product, and if only we can communicate our goals effectively to the people of Planet Ari.
And that's what we're going to try and accomplish today. We need a way to effectively communicate information to these citizens, and of course, we can't forget our CEO, Susie Sustain. She and the rest of our superiors need to stay in the loop as well. Oh, goody! I finally get to communicate with a citizen of Planet Ari in person. Of course, Olaf, you are responsible for fostering a positive relationship with potential customers, and you're the perfect snowman for the job. But what we need now is two team members to be a part of a formal communication channel so that we may communicate information to the levels above and below us back and forth to the adjacent units.
I would be more than willing to be a part of the formal communication channel. After all, I usually have questions, look for information and clarification, and love offering suggestions.
Thank you, Arwen. Actually, you'd be the perfect person for the job. From what you said, I think it would be best to make you responsible for the upward communication. And I was thinking Mr. Fox would be great for the role of downward communication. I think Mr. Fox would be very effective in communicating our objectives, directions, decisions, as well as provide feedback.
Why, thank you, Caesar. I would be honored to take the position.
Great. We have our formal communication, then.
But, Caesar, who will be responsible for lateral communication?
Oh, thanks for the reminder, Bob. Both Arwen and Mr. Fox can share in the responsibility for this role. They can share any information they gather with the rest of us, and we could all work together to joint problem solve.
Sounds great.
Great. Now let's discuss how we want to communicate with the citizens of Planet Ari. The cultural distance between the Planet Ari citizens and ourselves and Planet Ari and citizens, we need to find an effective communication method and build trust. Cultural distance? But Caesar, we are on the same planet as them. How is this a distance problem? Not a physical distance, Olaf. Cultural distance, the overall difference between two cultures' basic characteristics, such as language, level of economic development, and traditions with customs, it is one of the cultural barriers that we need to overcome in order to effectively communicate with the citizens of Planet Ari. Oh, that makes sense. So we need to improve our communication skills? Precisely. Bob and I were actually discussing this on the plane ride here, and he is going to send you all an email today with information to aid you all to improve your listening and sending skills, ways that can make the organizational level improvements in communication.
Yeah, I'll be sending that shortly. Speaking of email, Caesar, I also discussed the different modes and media of communication.
That's right, Bob. We all need to decide on a media of communication we want to use to transmit information to the citizens of Planet Ari. The media of communication can be divided into two different categories, rich media and lean media. Rich media provides several types of information and multiple ways to obtain a mutual understanding between the sender and receiver. It involves more face-to-face interactions. Lean media, on the other hand, is more impersonal and usually involves emails or memos. Well, I know that the people of Planet Ari are a private and proud people, but I am not sure if they would prefer being communicated with rich media or lean media.
I think that since we do not know for sure which method will be more effective, we can use both lean media and rich media for now. So we communicate through email and face-to-face. That way we can reach the majority of Planet Ari citizens and use their response and reactions as feedback to help us decide which media is more effective.
That's a great idea, Mr. Fox. Does everyone agree?
Yeah.
What
about the formal communication channel? What kind of media do you think Arwen and Mr. Fox should use for upward and downward communication? Well, as much as I prefer personal and face-to-face communication, I think it would be best to use lean media when communicating to our superiors because they are still located on Earth. Emails and memos would be easier and more effective because of the vast distance between the two headquarters.
Yes, Arwen, I agree. Good thinking. What about you, Mr. Fox? What kind of media would you like to use for downward communication?
I also think lean communication would be best. Since I will be communicating simple and straightforward information, I do not think it would be necessary to use a rich medium. It would involve too much time and effort from the receivers that they could be using to do something more productive.
And that way people won't see Mr. Fox rolling his eyes all the time. That's a good point too, Olaf. We've discussed and planned for everything we needed today. Great work, everybody. I think we've been very productive today. How about we take a break and go explore Planet Ari?
Yeah, great.
Yeah, great.